Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today we are on forfeiture of shares and reissue of shares which are forfeited. I'll be taking up forfeiture of shares issued at par in this video. Now this is a very important topic. Whenever you have company accounts issue of shares in your portion, then forfeiture of shares plays a major role. What is forfeiture of shares? Let us understand that. Forfeiture of shares means cancellation of shares, or I can say cancellation of shareholding. See, or we can also say taking back the shares. Who is taking back the shares? The company is taking back the shares. Understand, company gives shares to the public, company issues share to the public, right? Ab at that time public jab shares ko apply karti hai, when the public is applying shares, then the public promises that right now we are paying application money, and then whenever the company will call for the allotment amount, for the calls amount, first call, second call, whenever the company will call up, we will pay, right? That is an agreement between the public and the company. But in case if the public is not able to pay that amount which is being called up, what I'm saying, jo amount कंपनी ने कॉल किया वो अलॉटमेंट अमाउंट हो सकता है, वो फर्स्ट कॉल अमाउंट हो सकता है, वो सेकंड कॉल अमाउंट हो सकता है, या तीनों हो सकते हैं. कंपनी ने कॉल किया और पब्लिक ने अगर पे नहीं किया, देन फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल स्पेसिफिक नोटिस इज गिवन, सम टाइम इज गिवन, एंड इवन आफ्टर दैट इफ द अमाउंट इज नॉट बींग पेड बाय द शेयर होल्डर्स, देन देयर शेयर्स विल बी फोरफीटेड, दैट इज द शेयर्स विल बी टेकन बैक बाय द कंपनी. ओके, नाउ इन सच अ केस हाउ, so that shares first of all becomes shares of the company back, okay, and these shares are then being reissued. So reissued part I'll be taking on later on, and to understand the whole concept of forfeiture, first I'll be directly starting with one basic question to understand the whole concept, and then we'll jot down the points on how to pass the entry for share forfeiture. Forfeiture share entry is just one, but for this we need to understand the whole concept of shares issued, the journal entries for issue of shares. If you know that, then forfeiture is not that tough. So let us take up a question and we'll proceed further. So the question I'm taking right now is this one, Subhash Company Limited. This question number 7. Let us read it. Subhash Company Limited issues 2000 equity shares of 100 each. So 100 each. Payable as 30 on application, 30 on allotment, 40 on first and final call. All these shares were subscribed and duly allotted. First of all, I understood 100 each. That means this is the face value. Premium is not given. So these are the shares issued at par. While you are reading the question, question padne ke time pe important part ko wahi mark kar lo. Though what we do, question padke we do write in our working note the entire question so that we don't refer to the question again and again. But reading the question is very important in accounts. If you get a hang of this properly, then you will not have any issues. Okay, all these shares were subscribed and duly allotted. All these shares were subscribed means full subscription. What happened? Just a second. Yeah, I hope you all can also read the question. Okay, so all these shares were subscribed and duly allotted. That means the entire 2000 equity shares were applied and allotted. Company made all the calls. Okay, all the cash was duly received except the first and final call on 100 equity shares. These shares were forfeited by company and were reissued as fully paid up for 75 per share. So this reissued part I'll be taking at the last. We'll not discuss much of this right now. Now what do we do? First we note down the question in our solution. So I'll write working note. How many shares is the company issuing? The company is issuing 2000 shares and the face value is 100 each. Is the face value, right? Okay, and this is being issued at the time of application. How much money is there? So 30 on application, 30 on allotment, and 40 on first and final call. Okay. Application 30, allotment 30, and first and final call. So there is just one call here, is of 40. Okay. Then what has the question says? All shares were subscribed and duly allotted. Company made all the calls. This part is also important at the time of forfeiture. Company made all the calls. I'll make you understand in the rest of the questions that why is this part important. All cash was duly received except the first and final call on 100 equity shares. Okay, so this means that application and allotment amount was received in full. These two were received in full, but when it comes to final call, there were some shareholders holding 100 shares, right? It is 100. Okay, 100 equity shares, they did not pay the final call. Okay, so we'll just mark that 100 shareholders did not pay the final call. Okay, and then these shares were forfeited by the company. Let us start. Okay, now if the question is full like this, where you have basic application, allotment, calls, and then you have forfeiture, then start doing the entries which you know. Don't wait up till forfeiture. When we go there, we'll discuss about it. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, there are 2000 shares. Let me do my working note here itself. So my working note. Okay, so my working note, I have, first of all, application, we do the entry of received. How much amount would I have received? I would have received 2000 shares into 30, and the same amount would be due or transferred to share capital, same amount. Similarly, for allotment, first I'll do the entry of due or transfer. Again, the amount would be 2000 into 30, and the same is received because at the time of allotment also there is no problem. But when it will come to first and final call, we'll do the entry of due or transfer as 2000 into 40. However, we will receive, so 2000 into 40 is 80,000, but we will receive 100 shares pay. We did not got 40, did not get 40 rupees. So 100 into 40, we will not receive. Okay. Let us see. Let us directly go on to the journal entries now. So in the journal entries, we'll write in the books of Subhash Company Limited. Okay. So in the books of Subhash Company Limited, journal entries. Okay, let us start. So the first entry is of received share application amount, bank account debit to share application account or equity share application accounts, your wish. So to share application account. And the amount is how much? We said 2000 into 30, which is 60,000 debit and 60,000 credit. Now, I hope you guys know the narration. I'll just write a bracket because don't forget about the narration. Being share application amount received. Then next entry is of transfer. So share application, this in this question it was fully subscribed, so we don't have to think much about pro rata and everything. We can directly transfer the amount to share capital account. Amount is same, 60,000. Being share application money transferred to share capital. Then allotment. See, since in this question, rest all the things are easy, we can directly start doing the entries. And by this, you save time, plus accounts. The beauty is that you get step markings. So in case in one entry, if you're wrong, you get marks for the remaining entries which are right. So to share capital. Now, from allotment stage, there is the due and transfer entry first, and there is the entry of received. Okay, so share allotment account to share capital. The amount is again 2000 into 30. Which is 60,000, and we say being share allotment amount due. Being share allotment amount due, and then once you receive it, then the entry becomes bank account debit to share allotment account. Now There is no problem up till here. 60,000. 60,000. Even the first and final call was due. It was called up. Due means called up. So, share final call debit. And the amount was 40. 2000 into 40, which is 80,000. To share capital, you've called up the amount 80,000. 80,000. Narrations are important. You are also being share first and final call amount due. And now, when I talk about receive, so what did we read in the question? See, we've written in a working note that there were shareholders holding 100 shares who did not pay the final call money. You have two options in writing the entry. One is by making creating a calls in arrears account, or secondly, do not make a calls in arrears account and do the entry directly. So right now I'm doing the entry directly, but later on, once this question is done, I'll tell you how to go about it if you are creating a calls in arrears account. Let us see. So my sixth entry is bank account debit. See, I should have received 80,000. However, I am not receiving 40 rupees on 100 shares, which comes to 4,000. I am not receiving 4,000. So how much would I have actually received? I received only 76,000. And this goes to share final call account. 76,000. So here you can write the narration being share call amount received on, either you can write the word 1900 shares because you've not received on 100 shares. Just a second, 1900 into 40. I'm just checking the calculations again. So yes, it comes to 76,000. Now see, okay, I'll do one thing that beside this only I'll do the entry. If you are maintaining calls in arrears account, then what is the entry? Let us discuss that also. So if suppose I maintain calls in arrears account, then alternatively, or we can write the word or, this could have been the entry bank account debit. Whenever calls in arrears account is maintained, then this share final account is completely share final call account gets closed. So I would have done bank account debit 76 because I'm receiving only 76. I means the company. And you open a calls in arrears debit. So the company opens calls in arrears debit 4,000 to share final call 80,000. See, note one thing. If calls in arrears account is opened, then share final call debited by 80 and credited by 80. But if calls in arrears account is not open, then what can you see? That you can see that share final call is debited by 80. We'll be doing question like this. However, it is credited by 76,000. That means share final call account has a balance of 4,000 remaining. Okay. Now let us move on to the entry of share forfeiture. Like I told you, when the company is creating shares, see, when the company is issuing shares to the public, the company is opening this share capital account, correct? You can see that this share capital account is having a credit balance. This share capital account is having a credit balance. So see, we have credited share capital account here. We have credited share capital account here at the time of allotment, at the time of application, and we have also credited share capital account here at the time of final call. Basically, whenever the company is issuing shares and whatever amount the company is calling, share capital account is credited. Shares are being created in the book. Now, if you want to cancel the shares, share capital account will now be debited. So, for my forfeiture entry, first of all, share capital account would be debited, because I'm canceling the shares. When shares are being given, share capital account is credited. Now the shares are being cancelled, So the share capital account will be debited. So the first point comes is, okay, capital will be debited with how much amount? So you will see with whatever amount the share capital was credited, jitne amount se share capital credit hua tha, utne hi amount se ab share capital account debit hoga. Okay, to credit kitne se hua tha, dekhte hain. फिर मैं वर्किंग नोट से ही बताऊंगी. देखो यहाँ पे क्रेडिट हुआ था, शेयर कैपिटल इज ऑलवेज क्रेडिटेड विद फेस वैल्यू. सो हियर एट द टाइम ऑफ एप्लीकेशन द फेस वैल्यू वाज 30 ईयर. देन इवन एट द टाइम ऑफ अलॉटमेंट द फेस वैल्यू वाज 30, 30 प्लस 30 60, एंड एट द टाइम ऑफ फाइनल कॉल द फेस वैल्यू वाज 40. सो टोटल 100, 40 30 30 टोटल 100. दिस इज माई फेस वैल्यू. In two, will we cancel all the shares? There are total 2000 shares. Am I cancelling all the shares? No, I am just cancelling those 100 shares on which I did not receive the final call. So you will multiply with only those number of, so this is my number of shares which the company is wanting to forfeit. In this question, 100 shares the company is forfeiting. So 100 shares into 100 comes to 10,000. Okay, two, share final call. See, we just now discussed that. So what amount am I receiving, writing here? This share final call is nothing but amount which was due. Due means which was called up by the company and the shareholder has not paid. Ye kaun se account ko maine credit kiya? Jo account mein company ne paise call kiye the but public ne paisa nahi diya. Public matlab wo 100 shareholders ne. So dekho, inhone 4000 nahi diya tha, right? हम वापस लिख भी सकते हैं, 100 शेयर्स पे 40 रुपीज वॉज नॉट पेड. सो 100 इंटू 40, 4000 कम्स अप योर. एंड नाउ इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड, इफ यू आर एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड, सी नाउ योर शेयर फाइनल अकाउंट इज क्रेडिटेड. फर्स्ट शेयर फाइनल अकाउंट वॉज डेबिटेड बाई 80, इट वॉज 76 बाई, इट वॉज क्रेडिटेड बाई 76,000 एंड नाउ इट इज क्रेडिटेड बाई 4000. सो नाउ फाइनली योर शेयर फाइनल अकाउंट अकाउंट गेट्स क्लोज्ड. ओके, वॉट अबाउट द रिमेनिंग अमाउंट? The remaining amount means what? See, let's now go on to our working. These 100 shareholders who were holding 100 shares, they did not pay final call money, but they did pay the application allotment money. So what do you think? आपको क्या लगता है, ये पैसा कंपनी वापस दे देती है क्या? नहीं. Whenever the shares are forfeited, शेयर्स भी ले लिए जाते हैं और जो पैसे आपने अभी तक दिए थे, whatever amount the shareholder had paid to the company, that is retained by the company. आपको वो पैसे भी रिटर्न नहीं मिलेंगे और आपको शेयर्स भी नहीं मिलेंगे. शेयर्स भी कंपनी ले लेगी और आपने पैसा जो अभी तक पे किया था वो भी कंपनी ले लेती है. सो दिस 30 and 30, 60 रुपीज बिकम्स अ काइंड ऑफ इनकम फॉर द कंपनी और प्रॉफिट. बट आई टॉक अबाउट री इश्यू, वॉट इज द नेट प्रॉफिट, दैट विल गो लेटर ऑन. अभी आप समझ सकते हो दैट इज दिस 60 रुपीज नाउ बिलोंग्स टू द कंपनी. ओके, so it goes in share forfeiture या share forfeited account. Share forfeiture account लिखिए, share forfeited account लिखिए, does not matter. So how much is the amount coming? 100 into 60. You can take it as a balancing figure also. Debit and credit should match. So 6000 comes as a balance. Okay, so what did we understand about share forfeited account? We understood that what amount goes in share forfeited, whatever amount is received by the company on those shares which the company is now cancelling becomes our income, and that goes in share forfeited account. Since we were doing entry along with calls and arrears also, so let us do it here. That suppose if you would have done this entry, if you would have done this entry of calls and arrears, then what will your, what will be the entry of share forfeiture? So we are cancelling shares again, so share capital has to be debited now. But share capital is always debited with, credited with face value, so it will be debited also with face value. Also debited for how many shares? Only those shares which are being forfeited. In our question, 100 shares are being forfeited, so it will be debited by 10,000. Okay, then now since you had opened a calls in arrears debit account, calls in arrears we keep it in our account till the time money is not received. Now what is happening, we know that money will not be received and I am closing the, I am taking away the shares back, this calls in arrears will be credited. So whenever you are opening calls in arrears account, then in that case, at the time of forfeiture, this call account does not come. Share calls in arrears comes. Calls in arrears will be credited by 4000. So now you will realize that this 4000 which was debited is now being credited, and remaining 6000 is a profit or income. Share forfeited, yeah, share forfeiture account 6000. Okay, that will be the entry of share forfeiture. Okay, now coming, so let us first sum up on, let us write a summary on share forfeiture whenever shares are issued at par. See, when shares forfeiture of shares issued at par, what is the entry when forfeited shares are being issued at par? See, the entry is share capital account is debited. Now, with what amount is the share capital account debited? Share capital account is debited with number of shares forfeited. Number of shares forfeited. This is the main gist. Into called up value. Now, what is this word, ma'am? What do you mean by called up value? See, let us understand called up value and then we'll finish this. In our question right now, face value was 100, right? Face value was 100. Application was 30. Allotment was 30. And there was just one call, 40. And the question said that we have called up the entire amount, 100. And 40 rupees is not received. So in this question, what happened? This entire 30, 30 and 40 was called up. Matlab, all the amounts were already due. That means this entire amount which was called up, share capital was credited. Here these arrows of mine, these blue arrows. 30, 30 and 40 all was called up. And then you forfeited the shares. So sometimes the question will be where the entire called up and face value will be same. But there can be another case. Suppose now this is a case which I am taking. Suppose 100 was the face value. I am taking the same case. Application was 30. Allotment was 30. And call was 30. Call was 40. So total is 100. Suppose a shareholder did not pay allotment money. And the company forfeited the shares here itself. Here what is happening? Company ne abhi tak call kiya hi nahi hai. 40 wala amount call kiya hi nahi hai. Is shareholder ne allotment money 30 hi nahi pay kiya. To is case mein hum company ne called up kitna kiya tha? Called up value is just rupees 60. 30 plus 30. Because see, understand. Aapke application ke time pe aap entry karte ho received or due ki. Thik hai? Then allotment ke time pe bhi entry aapne ki hogi. I am writing here. Due or receive ki, right? अच्छा ये एंट्रीज तो हुई नहीं है तो दो ही बार आपने ड्यू किया मतलब दो ही बार अमाउंट शेयर कैपिटल में गया कितना गया 30 एंड 30 जब आपने शेयर कैपिटल को क्रेडिट ही 60 से किया है तो अब आप कितना डेबिट कर सकते हो 60 से ही डेबिट कर सकते हो सो व्हाट वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड इन केस ऑफ फोरफीचर वी विल टेक अप द सम शॉर्ट क्वेश्चंस आफ्टर आई फिनिश दिस क्वेश्चन टू अंडरस्टैंड द होल लॉजिक इन अ मच प्रॉपर वे बट whenever you want to now this is the main gist which you should note down that share capital account would be number of shares forfeited into called up value. Okay, this called up value can be equal to face value or it can be less depending on the question. Okay, to share forfeited account, yeah, to share forfeiture account, how much amount will go? Amount will be amount received on shares forfeited. जो शेयर्स आपने फोरफीट किए हैं उसके ऊपर अभी तक जितना भी अमाउंट आपको मिल चुका है दैट गोज इन आर शेयर फोरफीचर अकाउंट बिकॉज जब हम शेयर्स फोरफीट करते हैं तो हम अमाउंट भी रख लेते हैं हमारे पास वी डोंट गिव इट बैक टू द शेयर होल्डर एंड टू शेयर अलॉटमेंट और आई कैन राइट टू शेयर कॉल्स नाउ आई एम राइटिंग दिस बेसिकली दिस इज अमाउंट ड्यू but not received. Again, the important part is amount due but not received. If suppose the call was not called up, अगर ये कॉल्स का अमाउंट हुआ ही नहीं था कॉल, तो फिर सिर्फ शेयर अलॉटमेंट वर्ड आएगा. अगर आपने कॉल कर दिया तो कॉल वर्ड भी आएगा. अमाउंट ड्यू बट नॉट रिसीव्ड, मेन पार्ट इज अमाउंट शुड बी ड्यू. ओके, एंड इफ यू आर मेंटेनिंग कॉल्स इन अरियर्स अकाउंट, देन इंस्टेड ऑफ राइटिंग दिस यू कैन डायरेक्टली राइट द एंट्री एज टू शेयर फॉरफीचर एंड टू कॉल्स इन अरियर्स अकाउंट. Again, calls and arrears is the total of the amount which is due but not received. Okay, so it's the same. So this is the gist of forfeiture of shares issued at par. Okay, now let us move on to reissue of forfeited shares. See, what do you mean? Okay, let us understand the scenario in our question. What has happened up till now? Up till now, see, there were 2,000 shares. There were 2,000 shares which the company has issued to public. The company, we can see that in this question, the company has issued the entire, company has called up the entire amount, application, allotment and calls money. Pura amount call kar diya hai aur 100 shareholders ne final call nahi diya aur humne shares forfeit kar diya hai. Matlab humne shares forfeit kar diya hai. So today, after share forfeiture, there are only 1900 shares लेफ्ट विद द कंपनी, जो कंपनी ने पब्लिक को इश्यू किया है. 100 शेयर्स कंपनी के पास है. अब क्या करेगी, ये शेयर्स कंपनी रखेगी अपने पास? नहीं. दीज 100 शेयर्स द कंपनी कैन नाउ री इशू टू पब्लिक. अच्छा, बट री इशू में क्या होता है, इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी दैट अगेन एट द टाइम ऑफ री इशू हम एप्लीकेशन अलॉटमेंट फर्स्ट कॉल ऐसा मंगवाएंगे. नहीं, अब वो सब स्टेजेस की बात नहीं होगी. अब डायरेक्टली 100 रुपीज का शेयर या वो 100 शेयर जो फोफिट हुए उसे हम री इशू कर देंगे एट सम प्राइस. ओके, व्हाट द प्राइस कैन बी, उसकी अब बात करते हैं. पहले मैं क्वेश्चन का ही सोल्यूशन करूंगी एंड देन वी मूव अहेड. सो वी वर ऑन दिस सेवेंथ एंट्री. वेन एवर यू आर डूइंग द एंट्री ऑफ री इशू, यू फर्स्ट नीड टू नो व्हाट इज द एंट्री फॉर फॉरफीचर. सो हियर आई हैव दिस सेवेंथ पॉइंट इन फ्रंट ऑफ मी वेर आई नो व्हाट इज द एंट्री ऑफ फॉरफीचर एंड देन वील अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द एंट्री फॉर री इशू. Okay, I did not write the narration also, so we can just write being 100 shares forfeited for non-payment of call money, for non-payment of call money. Okay, eighth entry. Now let us read the question. What did it say, about reissue? So they are saying these shares were forfeited by the company and were reissued as fully paid for 75 per share. First of all, let's understand the meaning of fully paid. Fully paid means जो हमारे new shareholders होंगे, जिनको हम ये 100 shares आप देना चाहते हैं. सी, 100 शेयर्स कंपनी के पास है, फोफिट हो चुके हैं. अब ये मैं किसी न्यू शेयर होल्डर को दे रही हूँ, तो मैं उससे बोल रही हूँ ये 100 का शेयर है, आप 75 में ले लो. 100 का शेयर है मतलब अगेन जब मैं एंट्री करूँगी, पहली एंट्री हो जाएगी बैंक अकाउंट डेबिट. अंडरस्टैंड, बैंक अकाउंट कितने से डेबिट होगा? 100 शेयर्स, और हमको उसके ऊपर कितने रुपीज मिल रहे हैं? हमने 75 पर शेयर में वो शेयर्स री इशू किए हैं. सो आई एम रिसीविंग रुपीज 75, दैट मीन्स 7,500 इज द अमाउंट आई एम रिसीविंग. बट दीज आर फुल्ली पेड अप. फुल्ली पेड अप मतलब आप 75 में ले लो, इसके बाद हम आपसे 25 रुपीज और कॉल नहीं करेंगे. हम यही मानेंगे कि आपने भी 100 रुपीज ही दिए थे. ठीक है, दिए नहीं है, बट लाइक वील जस्ट अज्यूम कि इसके बाद और कोई लेना देना कंपनी और शेयर होल्डर में बाकी नहीं है. सो शेयर कैपिटल क्रेडिट होता है हमेशा फेस वैल्यू से. इवन योर शेयर कैपिटल विल बी क्रेडिटेड बाय 100 × 200 विच इज 10,000. सो नाउ यू कैन सी दैट द डेबिट एंड क्रेडिट इज नॉट मैचिंग द डिफरेंस इफ इट इज ऑन द डेबिट साइड. दिस इज बेसिकली अ लॉस. यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड कि 100 का शेयर मैंने 75 में दे दिया तो मुझे लॉस हो गया 25 का. दिस लॉस will be adjusted with this profit. हमको शेयर forfeited के टाइम पे प्रॉफिट हुआ था 60 रुपीज का, राइट? 60 रुपीज हमें मिले थे, तो ये शेयर 60 में से अब शेयर forfeited डेबिट हो जाएगा 100 × 25 विच इज 2,500. So being shares reissued at ₹75 fully paid up. Okay. And then now you can finally judge the net profit. Like now you can see that, okay, when 100 shares were forfeited, I had 6,000 with me. Okay. This amount. This amount 6,000. Out of this, these shares when they were reissued. See, we did discuss that shares cannot be issued at a discount. But reissue of forfeited shares can be at discount. However, discount can be maximum ₹16 in this case. मैंने क्या आपको बोला कि जो भी लॉस होता है वो लॉस आप किसके साथ एडजस्ट करेंगे, ये जो आपका शेयर फोफिटेड अकाउंट क्रेडिट हुआ है इसके साथ एडजस्ट करेंगे. सो इट इज सिंपल कि हमारा मैक्सिमम लॉस कितना हो सकता था, 60 का हो सकता था. सपोज मैं ये शेयर्स 30 पे री इशू कर देती, तो दैट मीन्स मेरा लॉस 70 का हो जाता. यहाँ पे क्या आ जाता, 7,000, यहाँ पे आ जाता 3,000. बट मैं मैक्सिमम कितना एडजस्ट कर सकती हूँ, आई कैन एडजस्ट ओनली 6,000. सो दिस केस इज नॉट पॉसिबल, कंपनी कैन नॉट री इशू एट सच अ लो प्राइस. बट कंपनी कुड री इशू एट 40, ओके, उसकी भी हम बात करेंगे. अभी मैं आपको बस एक हिंट दे दिया मैंने कि शेयर फोफिटेड अकाउंट कितने से मैक्सिमम डिस्काउंट कितना डेबिट हो सकता है, जितना ऑलरेडी अकाउंट में है उतने से वापस डेबिट हो सकता है. इन आर केस व्हाट हैपेंड, जब वो शेयर्स फोफिट किए तो 6,000 मेरे पास कंपनी के पास था, फिर वही शेयर्स जब मैंने री इशू किया. अच्छा, एक और एक चीज, अब मैंने वो शेयर्स वापस री इशू कर दिया. सो फ्रॉम कंपनीज पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू मेरे पास 1900 शेयर्स थे, अब वो 100 शेयर्स मैंने फिर पब्लिक को री इशू कर दिया है. सो अगेन 2000 शेयर्स कंपनी के पास अब दिख रहे हैं कैपिटल में. इसीलिए हमने शेयर कैपिटल अकाउंट को फिर यहाँ पे री इशू के टाइम पे हमने शेयर कैपिटल अकाउंट को क्रेडिट कर दिया था. दैट इज एंटायर 2000 शेयर्स आर नाउ कम बैक. जो 100 शेयर्स पहले कैंसिल हुए थे, फोफिट हुए थे, वो अब फिर क्रिएट हो गए बुक्स में. ओके, एंड आई एम ऑन दिस प्रॉफिट पार्ट. 6,000 में से 2,500 तो यहाँ एडजस्ट हो गया, सॉरी 2,500. ओके, सो हाउ मच इज लेफ्ट, 3,500 is my actual profit. Now this is my net profit. अब ये final profit है. देखिए, समझिए, company share forfeit करती है, उस time पे share forfeit जब करती है तो कुछ पैसा जो company जब्त कर लेती है, मतलब वो shareholder को पैसा भी नहीं मिलता और उसके shares भी चले जाते हैं, वो shares हमारे पास रहते हैं. वो अभी मेरा फाइनल प्रॉफिट नहीं है. दैट शेयर फोफिटेड अकाउंट इन द स्टार्ट, दिस 6,000 इज नॉट द फाइनल प्रॉफिट बिकॉज आई डोंट नो एट व्हाट प्राइस विल द शेयर्स बीइंग रीइश्यूड. नाउ यू विल से कि मैम व्हाई कांट द कंपनी रीइश्यू द शेयर्स एट 100 इटसेल्फ. सो सी, वंस द शेयर्स आर बीइंग गिवन टू द पब्लिक, देन द रेट, द मार्केट, द शेयर्स का वैल्यू क्या होना चाहिए, दैट इज डिसाइडेड बाय द मार्केट फोर्सेस. तो मार्केट में क्या रेट चल रहा है अभी इस टाइम पे, जब शेयर्स री इशू करने थे तब मार्केट में रेट 100 रुपीज का शेयर 75 कम पे चल रहा था. इफ द कंपनी डिसाइड्स कि ओके 75 पे भी मैं बेच देती हूँ तो ठीक है, 25 का लॉस हो गया. स्टिल कंपनी के लिए वो लॉस नहीं है. क्यों? क्योंकि कंपनी के पास तो 6,000 था, उसमें से ठीक है 2,500 लॉस भी हो गया, तो फाइनल नेट प्रॉफिट इज 3,500. एंड द लास्ट एंट्री बिकम्स, सो एट द टाइम ऑफ री इश्यू देर आर टू एंट्रीज. लास्ट एंट्री इज शेयर फोफीटेड अकाउंट डेबिट. नाउ यू विल क्लोज दिस शेयर फोफीटेड अकाउंट एंड द प्रॉफिट विल बी गोइंग टू कैपिटल रिजर्व एंड द अमाउंट वुड बी 3,500. Okay. So it will be being share forfeited amount transferred to capital reserve. So this was about this one question. We'll quickly write the gist here and then. So see, what did we discuss about share forfeited? That whenever shares share forfeiture, I am writing the entry of share forfeiture again first, issued at par. So what did we discuss? That whenever shares are forfeited, share capital account is debited with what amount? With called up amount, called up value, whatever the company has called up, into number of shares which are being forfeited to share forfeited account. Share forfeited account mein kaun sa amount jata hai? Amount which is already received on the shares which are forfeited and which is not received, either it goes in calls in arrears account or it goes in respective calls. So suppose share allotment ka paisa bhi nahi mila tha, to share allotment aayega. Agar mil chuka tha, to fir seedha share first call, share second call. Basically, jo bhi amount pe paisa nahi mila hai, wo credit hoga. And if you are maintaining calls in arrears account, then ye teen naam nahi, seedha calls in arrears aajayega. So this is amount due but not received. Okay, this is share forfeiture. And then reissue. In case of reissue, there are two entries. First entry of is of amount received. So that entry is bank account debit. See, basically is bank account debit to share capital. Okay, basically the entry is this. Suppose like 100 ka share hai aur wapas humko 75 ke badle 100 mil jata, to then sirf bank debit to share capital aa jata. Agar loss hua तो हम शेयर फोफिटेड को डेबिट करते हैं. जैसा हमारे क्वेश्चन में हुआ, 100 का शेयर हमने रीइश्यू किया, 75 में 25 का लॉस हुआ, तो शेयर फोफिटेड में आया. अच्छा, ऐसा भी तो हो सकता है कि कंपनी की मार्केट वैल्यू बढ़ चुकी है, मार्केट में अब वो शेयर्स 100 के बदले 110 में मिल रहे हैं और मेरे शेयर होल्डर्स भी लेने को रेडी है. इट इज पॉसिबल. रीइश्यू ऑफ शेयर्स कैन बी इशूड एट पार, कैन बी इशूड एट डिस्काउंट, कैन बी इशूड एट प्रीमियम. अगर प्रीमियम होता है तो वी नो दैट it goes in securities premium. So there can be three cases at the time of reissue. We'll take up some questions in the next video and understand how the entries are to be done in all the cases. It is not tough. It is simple entry of issue of shares. So this will be the first entry. Either only bank debit to share capital, or bank debit share forfeiture debit to share capital, or bank debit share capital and securities premium. Three things. Okay. And my next entry would be whatever. Oh, sorry. It should be amount. My next entry would be share forfeited. Whatever the remaining balance is left in share forfeited account will be debited to capital reserve. Even one more thing, I'll just say, we'll discuss this in the next video when we take up some questions. That see, in this question, what I did in this question, I did 6000 share forfeited account minus 2500 and I got 3500. When can I do this? I can do this only when the number of shares which were forfeited all are being reissued. Hamare case mein 100 shares humne forfeit kiye the aur wahi 100 shares humne pure reissue kar diye, to profit humne simply 6000 mein se 2500 minus karke la liya. Agar 100 shares forfeit karte aur thoda hi reissue karte, to in that case जितने रीइश्यू करते सिर्फ उसकी बात होती. दैट आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो. टिल देन स्टे ट्यून टू माय चैनल एंड फॉर एनी डाउट्स यू कैन फील फ्री टू मैसेज मी और कॉल मी ऑन द नंबर गिवन इन द डिटेल्स. थैंक यू.